In all my years of not starving, I have given crap tons of crap to both Twiggy Trees and Juicy Berry Bushes. Not really because they are bad, because they ain't per se. It's mostly due to me just preferring the classic saplings and such. But that being said, I'd be a fool not to cover the alternatives, so let's do that, shall we? And believe it or not, our journey today begins in the world generation settings, as we need to discuss one setting in particular. Starting resource variety. To keep things simple, know that classic settings will generate our world with normal saplings and berry bushes with no additional fuss for the most part. Default settings may or may not generate the resource alternatives in question, as things will vary from world to world, obviously. However, do know that world regrowth itself will have a say eventually, but more on that later. And finally, highly random means exactly that. You might get all kinds of resource combinations and alternatives all in one stinking world. All this to say is that classic mode is one of the only ways not to have these alternative plagues, various resources spawn in our worlds. But let's finally talk about them, shall we? Like most trees, Twiggy Trees have stages of growth, which each stage providing various amounts of resources each. Also similar to other trees, we can always choose to just dig up the remaining stumps for additional logs along the way. Even at their tallest though, Twiggy Trees will only drop 2 twigs total, but it's really the mechanics that work behind the scenes and that follow their felling that actually matter. For you see, normal and tall Twiggy Trees will begin to drop Twiggy Tree cones that we can use to replant additional Twiggy Trees where we wish, just like with normal pine cones. We can relocate saplings all the same, sure. However, Twiggy Trees are not only incapable of becoming diseased when relocated, they continue to grow all throughout winter, very much unlike our traditional saplings. It is quite nice to have in emergencies, or perhaps just in addition to normal saplings anyways, and 2 twigs per chop is better than 1 per pick last time I checked. But there is more. Twiggy Trees somewhat have their own renewability mechanics when it comes to twig production, as when an old Twiggy Tree becomes a tier 1 again, the tree itself will drop or spawn a single twig on the ground around itself. However, there can't be many other twigs around or else this won't occur, but still, Twiggy Trees kinda just produce for us, even when we are doing diddly squat to them. They are honestly not bad, if patience is what you have, and really, all this video is player's choice. So in that case, let's talk juicy berry bushes and why some players may choose them instead. First of all, you must know this. Either your world generates with juicy berry bushes in place of every single normal berry bush spawn, including moose goose areas, or they won't spawn at all. That is, until world regrowth has its way. But even then, I am 98.75% sure that our worlds need to be on endless mode for it to happen, as the florid postern itself is the actual thing that spawns new grass tufts, berry bushes, saplings, etc. In layman's terms, if your worlds do not spawn with juicy berry bushes initially, they will eventually begin to pop up down the road. Juicy berry bushes can be picked and or dug up all the same as normal berry bushes. However, you will notice immediately that the actual berries gathered are not the same at all. When harvested, these bushes drop 3 juicy berries each time, which sounds absolutely incredible. But let's talk the downsides here. For one thing, such an incredible bounty will always be locked behind a bigger paywall. And in this case, that happens to be a doubled growth time. Juicy berry bushes can be relocated, refertilized, utilized, and harvested all the same, but you will have to wait much longer to take advantage of them over the normal berry bushes. Oh, and they can still become diseased too, mind you. And another disadvantage is the increased spoilage time of juicy berries over that of regular ones. And in this case, of the actual cooked variants, that falls to merely 1 day only. It is not great, even considering limiting the use of an icebox, so you really, really need to only harvest juicy berry bushes when you truly need to. In terms of stat distribution, though, you will enjoy much more hunger and a bit more health over our normal berry cousins. Oh, and juicy berries can substitute for normal berries in crockpot dishes, just so you know. And, well, that's unfortunately it, folks. Certainly unceremonious, but there really ain't much else to say. So now perhaps you kind of understand why not actually spawning with these alternative resources isn't really a big deal at all. Besides, world regrowth could very well provide you some down the line anyways. Again, player choice. That is all that matters here, really. Thanks for watching, folks. Well wishes to all, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.